'Twas a month before Christmas. Santa, snug in his chair, was reading a book when he had an idea. Why not invite Crossroads to the North Pole this year to learn the true story of why Christmas is here? So he pulled out his list and indeed checked it twice, then began readying his home for that night. He trimmed out the tree with bright balls and a bow, and arranged all the presents in neat little rows. Then he went to his workshop and checked every toy, made sure all were perfect for each girl and each boy. When he had finished, he grabbed paper and pen and wrote invitations in the hopes you'd attend. Soon after all the work had been done, he sat down for a cookie, but enjoyed only one. You see, he's waiting for you to share this wonderful plate. He hopes to see you all soon. Write it down. Save the date. Crossroads presents our Christmas Spectacular, December 23rd.
May I have your attention, please? Listen up. This is Gabriel. With all cherubim, seraphim, and all the heavenly hosts, fly immediately to the Angel Academy Rehearsal Hall. It's time to warm up your vocal cords because Mary and Joseph have just arrived in Bethlehem. That's right, angels, hurry! This could be the glorious night we've been waiting for! Could this be the night when we take our flight? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the night? Could this be the moment we've been waiting for? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the night? Could this be the day when we get to say glory in the heights to the Lord of Lords? Hey, 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 could this be the day? Could this be the time we're ready to shine? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the time? Could this be the day we sing a peace on earth? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the day? Could we bring the news, the wonderful news? Could we bring the news of Jesus' holy birth? Hey, 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 could this be the day? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the day? Hey, Gabriel, could this be the day?
And your trumpet playing was top-notch, Gabriel. Excuse me, I didn't mean to barge in.
Oh, hi, Michael. We're all so excited and all armed up and ready to go.
Well, look who I found out and about. Harpo and Halo Hattie. They were out gallivanting around the galaxies without permission. The prayer circuits were overloaded with concerns about what was going on in the sky. So I had to fly out and take a look. And sure enough, there they were, surfing on some shooting stars.
Harpo, Halo, not again.
Dude, we don't Yeah, we were fully stoked.
Sure, fully.
Harpo, you know you're not supposed to leave your post. Halo, this is against the rules.
And especially today of all days. We are all waiting for the Father's orders to fly to Earth and make the big announcement. It could be any minute now. Angel alert! Places! That was close. We need to knock a few seconds off. Angels, at ease.
Michael, Ike, we're so sorry. We really didn't mean to leave.
It all happened this morning while we were finishing our chores. I was cleaning the windows in one of the mansions.
Me too. And I looked out the window and got an awesome creation. Hill and I just had to get out there and take a closer look. The next thing, we were paddling out and climbing the clouds.
We were so happening.
Harpo and Halo Hattie, look, I know you didn't mean any harm, so now just get in line. You need to promise me, really promise me, that you'll be patient and wait for the Father's orders.
We promise.
And speaking of promises, tonight could be the very night the promised Messiah is born. For God promises,
He will do.
God sent us to Abraham that day to tell he would have some governor.
And remember when God sent us
to Moses years ago,
he promised to be with him when he went to see old Pharaoh.
And then we told old Joshua to march around the town. Those mighty walls of Jericho, they all came tumbling down.
So I warned the people with that, like no they ever
learned. God always keeps his promises, God always keeps his word. When God says it, you can believe it. Every word he says will always come true. When God says it, you can believe it. Cause every promise in the book he will do.
With the news that she would bear the Son of God, the Lord has chosen you.
And remember when God sent us to Joseph in a dream, the child born of Mary will come to set men free.
But you, Bethlehem, though you are small, out of
They're like sheep without a shepherd. That's why the Father is sending his Son. And I'll let you in on a little secret. I know his name. They will call him Jesus.
No, you guys have got to see this.
No, Halo, not now.
But look, you've got to see what's going on.
Harpo, no, I don't need to see anything. I'm waiting for the Father's command.
But there's something.
Settle down, you two. Now, the scriptures say, one day, at the very name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus, the baby being born any minute now, is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Angel alert! Places! Better. Much better. We're getting there. Angels, at ease.
Excuse me, Michael. Do you mean every knee will bow to Jesus?
Yes. Every knee will bow.
Even him?
Yes, Angelica. Yes, especially him. Lucifer, yes, Lucifer, was at one time an archangel. like me. But he was banished from heaven because of pride and his unwillingness to follow the Father's orders, to honor God. He took almost one-third of the angels with him. But angels, fear not. God is in control, and he has a plan. He is sending his son down to save his people from their sins. Oh, my dear cherubim, seraphim, and all the heavenly hosts, the Savior of the world has been born. He is Christ the Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus came about. Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken over the entire Roman world. So Joseph and Mary begin their long and tiring journey to Bethlehem. And when they arrived, they searched for the place to stay. But the city was crowded, and the inns were full. There was no room for them. For the baby to be born, and Mary gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger. A lonely, humble stable was the birthplace of our King.
The lady's 9 months pregnant.
And they couldn't find a room anywhere in Bethlehem. Every place was full. so they had to stay in the stable for all places.
And wait, there's more. She gave birth to Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Are you with me? Our Lord Jesus is lying in swaddling clothes.
Like in a feeding trough.
In a stable.
We know. We were briefed on the birth 10 minutes ago.
Oh, but wait, there's more. We were just out there, and we saw...
Stop right there. Not another word.
But wait, you guys, sounds like so 5 minutes ago.
Hoppo and Halo, stop. And now, I'm going to have to ground you both from flying tonight. Now go on the back and hang up your rings.
What?
What are you talking about?
No, I'm sorry. You will not be going to Earth with us tonight to make the big announcement. You simply were unable to follow orders. You two will be grounded. You need to go back and prepare the angel Coco.
What? Coco? We want to share the good news, not be in the kitchen.
Now run along and get cooking. We'll fill you in on the trip when we get back.
Bogus, dude.
Now get ready, angels. I'm sure any minute
we'll be leaving for Earth, so stretch. Warm up your wings. Fasten your halos.
Yeah, we want to go!
We knew the baby hadn't been born in Bethlehem, but when did the Father want us to announce it? We patiently waited.
Sir, it's time. Angel alert! Places!
The Father was sending us to Bethlehem. We were still surprised he had chosen shepherds to give us fantastic news to. But hey, we follow orders. So to the shepherds we went. With my heart racing, I gathered all the angels. Then I flew to the front and led the announcement.
Do not be afraid. We bring you good news.
Unto you a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord. Glory in the highest. Glory to God we send. Fear not, they freak out. Humans.
Heavenly Hotline, Michael speaking. Excuse me? What happened? Oh, really? Can you wait a minute, please? Where's Harpo and Halo? I need to know where they are right now.
They're in the kitchen. You know, we sent them earlier. I just saw them.
Well, it's not Harpo and Halo Hattie. They're both here. Listen, I'll be right there to check it out. The prayer circuits have been overloaded. Again. I suspect that it's some suspicious behavior on Lucifer's end, but I'll have to go check it out.
And angels, let's take a look and see how Joseph and Mary are doing. I wonder if they understand that the Savior of the world is in their arms.
Found out why the prayer circuits were over We're jammed with requests.
What happened?
Well, it seems my hunch was right. Lucifer was very upset about Jesus' birth, and he sent out his followers to try and confuse the wise men from being able to follow the star.
Oh, no, he wouldn't do such a thing.
Oh, yes, he would do such a thing. But don't worry, I understand there were two very brave angels on the scene who worked very hard to make sure that the star over Bethlehem was clearly seen.
Yay!
What angels? Who was that?
Well, I was told that it was Harpo.
Harpo?
And Miss Halo Hattie.
Halo?
They were trying to tell us earlier, but we wouldn't let them finish. So look now. Because of their help, the beautiful Bethlehem star is shining brightly. And the wise men are right on time.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth.
Angelica, would you get Harpo and Halo Hattie? We need to thank them for their help on the Bethlehem Star.
Yeah!
We also need to fill them in on our exciting announcement to the shepherds.
That's right, we did promise them. Yes, Harpo and Halo Hattie, Gabriel and I, and all the angels, we want to thank you too.
What?
What?
We were told how you two made sure the Bethlehem Star was clearly seen, shining brighter than ever over the manger.
You two are such angels, really.
We now know that you both were trying to tell us earlier about Lucifer's schemes, but we didn't take the time to listen. Thank you. The wise men made it safely to the manger and were able to worship our Savior, and it was all because of you.
And we want to say thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
We were honored to be of service.
It was a privilege.
Now, Harpo and Hale Hattie, have a seat. We just have to tell you about our visit to Earth, the night that changed the world.
Angels, I need your attention. I just received word that the Father's plan is already in motion. Shepherds have been seen running through the streets of Bethlehem, announcing Christ's birth. They're telling everyone what they've seen and heard. The message is going out. Jesus, the Savior of the world, is being born.
Roll call. Cherubim?
Here.
Seraphim?
Here.
And the multitude of heavenly hosts.
Here!
Our work has just begun, and our duties have expanded. Every time someone puts their faith in Jesus Christ as their Savior, it is our privilege, angels, to celebrate and praise the Father together.
And no doubt, the heavenly hotlines will be busier than ever. So Gabriel, sound the trumpet. Angel alert! Places! Celebrate!
Yeah.
was a month before Christmas. Santa, snug in his chair, was reading a book when he had an idea. Why not invite Crossroads to the North Pole this year to learn the true story of why Christmas is here? So he pulled out his list and indeed checked it twice, then began readying his home for that night. He trimmed out the tree with bright balls and a bow, and arranged all the presents in neat little rows. Then he went to his workshop and checked every toy, made sure all were perfect for each girl and each boy. When he had finished, he grabbed paper and pen and wrote invitations in the hopes you'd attend. Soon after all the work had been done, he sat down for a cookie, but enjoyed only one. You see, he's waiting for you to share this wonderful plate. He hopes to see you all soon. Write it down. Save the date. Crossroads presents our Christmas Spectacular, December 23rd. Oh, 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 oh.